The spray guns are very important while engaging the air compressors. They are the conduits through which the pressurized air is channeled from the tank to the desired target. To be able to be certain of the best experience, it is necessary to know just how to make use of these wonderful pieces of equipment. These form the basis of our discussions here. We are going to examine the step-by-step procedures you should follow to enjoy the best ever experiences of these wonderful gadgets. Wear proper outfit. Start off by wearing the proper protective outfits. While this is not mandatory, it is, by all means, crucial, especially if you want to use the device in a dusty place. This is because it is not uncommon for fumes, particulate matter, and other debris from flying around as you engage the spray gun in such conditions. The aprons, gloves, respirator, and overalls are some of the outfits you don't want to forfeit. Prepare the intended targets. The targets vary from circumstance to circumstance. This stems from the fact that the spray guns and air compressors as a whole are used for various tasks and purposes. If you plan to inflate a tire, prepare the valve. If you, however, want to blow off the dust from a surface, get rid of any excess debris, and so on. Prepare your air compressor. Now move on to prepare the air compressor itself. Turn it on and wait for the pressure to build up to the desired levels. You may also set the pressure levels in case your model allows for it. Make appropriate pressure adjustments if you have to. Check your manuals and refer to them periodically to avoid any hassles and unnecessary inconveniences. Connect the air hose tightly. After you are satisfied with the pressure levels, you now have to go ahead and connect the air hose tightly. This air hose comes ordinarily along with a sprayer. Because of this, it has to be completely airtight and devoid of any possibilities of the escape of air. As soon as you are through with connecting the air hose tightly, you now have to set the sprayer. To do this, press the trigger as you aim the nozzle in a waste bucket. Keep pressing till all the droplets of dust, debris, and previous paints are completely eliminated. In case no air is oozing out of the nozzle, you might want to disassemble the constituent parts to check out for the root cause of the problem. This may require some expert knowledge, and you are thus advised against attempting it on your own. Reassemble the parts once you are done. Commence spraying. You are now good to go. You should proceed now to commence spraying the surface you have in mind. Press the trigger of the nozzle to start off the spraying process. Keep a comfortable distance between the surface you are impacting and the sprayer. This should ideally be approximately 8-12 inches. You do not want the nozzle to be chalked or blocked with the bouncing debris, do you? Turn off the air compressor. At the conclusion of the spraying exercise, switch off the compressor. Follow this by detaching the nose and then clearing the room you have sprayed. If you were painting, be sure to return the remaining paint into the original container and store accordingly. Clean your paint sprayer. Lastly, you want to clean the sprayer. Whether to or not to clean the sprayer largely depends on the exact purpose to which you devoted it. Cleaning is compulsory if you were painting or blowing dust. You want to get rid of any dust, debris, or droplets of the paints. You will have to first and foremost disassemble the sprayer and clean the constituent parts individually. This process may entail soaking the parts in water for some time to loosen the dirt. P.S. Take great care that you do not injure or harm your finger as you press the trigger. Many users of these gadgets have reported blisters and bleeding as a result of improper handling of the nozzles. Can I use an air compressor to spray paint? If the spray gun that you have requires an air compressor, then the answer is yes. If the spray gun is an airless gun, then the answer is no. You must read the manufacturer instructions to determine if you need an air compressor to be connected to your spray gun. What size air compressor do I need to run a paint sprayer? The size of the air compressor that it will take to operate a spray gun are determined by the size and style of the spray gun. Because there are so many variations, there is no way to answer this question other than to tell you that for the majority of paint sprayers rated for 6 CPM and 30T040 PSI in compressor with a 1 to 2 horsepower motor will be fine. Do you need a compressor for a paint sprayer? There are paint sprayers that require you to connect them to an air compressor in order for them to function. There are also paint sprayers that are airless and require no air compressor. There are even sprayers that have their own compressor designed in them. You will need to read your instructions to see if your sprayer requires a compressor. What size air compressor do I need for a spray gun? The size of the air compressor that it will take to operate a spray gun are determined by the size and style of the spray gun. Because there are so many variations, there is no way to answer this question other than to tell you that for the majority of paint sprayers rated for 6 cpm and 30T040 psi in compressor, with a 1 to 2 horsepower motor will be fine. How big of an air compressor do I need for a HVLP spray gun? The size of the air compressor that it will take to operate a spray gun are determined by the size and style of the spray gun. Because there are so many variations, there is no way to answer this question other than to tell you that for the majority of paint sprayers rated for 6 cpm and 30T040 psi in compressor, with a 1 to 2 horsepower motor will be fine. While using the sprayer gun is an activity which does not require too much expertise on your part, you nevertheless have to do some consistent practices to be able to become a pro. It is a concept you just cannot master by attempting it for the first time. In particular, you will have to exercise great patience and care while painting or performing other complicated chores. That's it for this video. We hope it has helped you. If so, please be sure to like and subscribe. We will see you soon.